Welcome back. If you are new, thank you for tuning in. My name is Sandra, and this is, again, another makeup tutorial. For today's video, I wanted to go ahead and create another look using the Too Faced Chocolate Gold palette right here. I love this palette, especially the shimmers in it, and it just has so much potential for different looks, and what better time to use it than a Valentine's Day. If you're gonna be going out with your boyfriend or significant other and celebrating, this look might just be for you. But even if you're not, and if you're gonna be at home watching movies, eating junk food, pizza, chilling with your dogs, you know, honestly, like, I would still rock this. I loved how it turned out. It is definitely glam and glowy, and I think it'll be really cute. So if you guys are interested in seeing how I accomplished this look, let's go ahead and jump into the tutorial. I'm gonna start prepping my face using the Coconut Rose Hydrating Face Mist by Pearl Essence. I'm just gonna go ahead and apply a little bit onto the face. You want to take a big brush and just press it into the skin just to help speed up the process of it absorbing onto the face. The primer I'm going to be using today is this one by Wet n Wild. It is mattifying lightweight formula, and it refines the appearance of pores, so we definitely want to apply a little bit of this onto the skin before our foundation. And I'm just going to go ahead and take a pea size and then put it on the T-zone. That I'm gonna be using is gonna be this product by Loreal. It is their Lumi Glowtion. I went ahead and saw a commercial of this on TV not that long ago, and I honestly haven't seen any reviews or any YouTube videos, at least, that have popped up currently, so I wanted to go ahead and try it out for myself. It's supposed to give you a natural glow, so we want to go ahead and do that because we are going for a full glam look, and we want to make sure we're nice and glowy and our skin looks nice and radiant. So I'm going to go ahead and apply a little bit of this onto the face. For foundation today, I'm gonna be taking this one by Maybelline. It is their Superstay foundation. It claims to be 24-hour oil-free. It doesn't clog your pores. It goes on seamlessly, and it is full coverage. So everything a oily girl would want. So I'm gonna go ahead and try this out. It is my first time using it, so we will see how it applies. Taking my BH Cosmetics flat top kabuki brush, I'm gonna go ahead and blend out my foundation. Okay, so our foundation is on, and so is our brows. We still look a little crazy, but you know, the end result is what we're striving for today. So let's go ahead and keep it going. Moving on to the eyes, I'm gonna be going into my chocolate gold palette. I'm taking the color Rolling in Dough, which is this one right here, and I have to put it up to you guys backwards because the mirror is in the way. But I'm gonna go ahead and pick up Rolling in Dough and apply it all over my eyelid. For my transition shade, I am gonna be taking this one by Makeup Geek. It is called Frappe, and I'm gonna be taking it on a Morphe M533 fluffy brush, and I'm gonna start applying that on the crease. When I'm blending this out, I am flicking it outward because I want to give myself a little bit of a cat eye look, since we are doing an intense, smoky, sultry eye look. And just continue to build that color up until you have the intensity that you want. color I'm taking is this one. It is Cocoa Truffle from the palette, and it is just a deeper brown. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply that just below that transition shade that we just applied to deepen up our crease. And the brush that I'm gonna be using is the Morphe M433. Picking up, it's Hala for Adala, which is a black shadow with gold specks. So definitely what I want, because this is the golden glam smoky eye look. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply it, this one. And the brush that I'm gonna be using is this e.l.f. eyeshadow brush. It's just a small packing brush. When applying this color, make sure you keep it low. You don't want to go up too high, because when we blend it out, it's just gonna move the product upwards, and so we don't want to end up looking like a little panda. Taking my M433 brush, we're gonna go back in with Cocoa Truffle and blend out those harsh edges. Patience is key when creating looks like this one, especially because we are working with darker shades. We want to make sure that we're blending them out nicely. So as you can see, I went back and forth between my M433 brush and then my M533 brush. So just swapping brushes as I'm applying product and blending each shadow out. And then I'm going to take Chocolate Gold, which is this gold shade right here from the palette, and I'm going to just apply a little bit of that to just make our eye pop on the center of the lid. And I'm just gonna apply it with my finger. For applying my concealer, I wanna go ahead and brighten up and prime this area under the eye. So I'm gonna be taking the Revlon Photo Ready Prime and Brightener. I'm gonna go ahead and use this under my eyes. It looks like this. It is in a salmon shade, so it cancels out any blue or purple that I might have under my eyes. I don't have horrible under eye bags, but I do wanna brighten it up and make it look nice and bright once we apply that concealer. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply a little bit of this onto the under eyes. For concealer today, I'm taking this one by Rimmel. It is their Match Perfection in the shade Fair. I love this formula. It's super creamy. It doesn't dry my under eyes. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply some of this under my eyes to conceal. And spray my beauty blender, and I'm gonna start working this into the under eyes. Contour my face, and I'm gonna be taking this palette by CoverGirl. It is their True Blend Contour Palette, and it has three different shades. So I always go for a little bit of a darker shade, just because we are gonna blend it out. And I'm gonna take these two shades first, this one and this one. I'm gonna apply this one first, and then this one to contour. When applying this product, you want to press it into the skin and not rub it around so that we don't disturb the concealer or the foundation underneath and create patchy skin. And then next I'm gonna be picking up this color in the center and I'm gonna do the same step and just deepen up our contour. To set my concealer, I'm picking up my Maybelline Fit Me Loose Finishing Powder in the shade Fair, which is number 10. I'm gonna go ahead and use this powder to bake under the eyes just to set our concealer. And I'm just gonna pick it up in my beauty sponge and apply it under the eyes. To set my contour and bronze up my face, I'm gonna be taking my MAC Give Me Sun and a big fluffy brush. I'm just gonna go ahead and start warming up my face and setting that contour in place. I wanna be super bronzy and sun-kissed for this look. So, we gonna do that. To clean up our contour a little bit, I'm just gonna go ahead and pick up a little bit of that Fit Me Loose setting powder and I'm just gonna go ahead and use this e.l.f. contour brush and then just press it and clean that up. So that we have a sharper contour. To give my face a little color, and because I'm obsessed with blush, I'm gonna be using this one by Wet n Wild. It is called Apricot in the Middle, and it looks like this. It has a natural sheen to it, which I love because on times wherein you don't wanna highlight, this will provide that for you, but I mean, we're still gonna highlight today. I'm just gonna go ahead and pick up a little bit on an angled brush, tap off the excess, and apply it to the apples of my cheeks. That like natural glow, super pretty. The rest of the face, I want to go ahead and finish out our eyes, so I'm going to go ahead and pick up this MUA Professionals small precise blending brush and pick up the color Cocoa Truffle from the palette and start blowing out that lower lash line. I'm gonna pick up Decadent and just place it on the outer corners. I'm gonna go in with my Tarte eyeliner. This is in the shade Bronze. And I'm just gonna apply it on the lower lash line just to intensify that smoky look. Want to just go back in with a little bit of Cocoa Truffle to blend that out. As usual, I do not wear fake lashes, so at this point go ahead and pop on your falsies. I'm gonna go ahead and use my Colossal Volume Express and Lash Sensational, give my lashes a curl, and then I will meet you right back. Okay, so I finished my mascara and I think it looks pretty damn good. So we're gonna go ahead and move on to highlight. I'm gonna be using Champagne Pop by Becca Cosmetics and Jaclyn Hill. I'm gonna be taking my damp beauty blender and I'm just gonna go ahead and pat it into the highlight. And then I'm just gonna apply it on the high points of my face. I love using this method because it just melts it into the skin and it doesn't just sit on top, making it look powdery. It just looks like you're truly glowing from within. Look at that highlight. Just gonna apply it on this side. And you wanna apply highlight in the areas where the light naturally hits you. That way it accentuates your features. Now that we're glowing like a disco ball, we're gonna go ahead and set our brows. I'm gonna be using my Maybelline brow pre-size. You guys already know this is my go-to brow to set my brows, and I like doing this step after I have applied all of my powder so that I'm not like having crusty brows, you know. And before I forget, let's go ahead and highlight our inner corner. I'm just gonna grab a little bit of that highlight and apply it right in there. Just to open up that eye area. So see how that makes a huge difference. And it just ties the look together. Moving on to my lips, I'm gonna be using this lip liner by Jordana in Rockin' Rose. I'm gonna go ahead and align my lips. For lips today, I'm gonna be using this Loreal Infallible Pro Matte Liquid Lipstick in the shade Cowboy. It is a nice soft formula. It does not make my lips crusty and I love the shade. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply this onto the lips. I think it'll complement the look very nicely. It is a nice brownie tone. If you're looking for liquid lipsticks to try out and you're a newbie to the makeup world and you just don't know how to go about finding the right formula or the right one, I know some can be super drying on the lips and it can make them look crusty or they can be super messy. These L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte Liquid Lipsticks are awesome. I love the formula, they're easy to apply. The applicator is different than any other ones that I have, so it does make it easy to apply it even if you're not using a lip liner. Even though I do suggest using a lip liner because it is literally like your little chart to help you stay within the lines. But if you're new, try these or try ColourPop. They're my ultimate favorite. Last but not least, we are gonna go ahead and set our face. As usual, I love using this Milani Make It Last Setting Spray. It is 16-hour wear and it works wonders for my oily skin. Keeps me nice and matte throughout the day, so I love this product. So I'm gonna go ahead and spray it. And that finishes up the look.